All right. What's going on, guys? It's Jev. Thank you so much for the intro suggestion, Vila. I hope you're having a great day. Jev most likely is not. He's probably going crazy about those obsidian weapons again. Leave your intro suggestions in the comments section below and you might appear in the next video. Late last night, we had a little oopsie, and this oopsie came in the form of an update on the Call of Duty website. This Call of Duty website update accidentally added a new message that simply said, "Welcome to Outbreak, a new large-scale zombies experience." When I go to the website right now, in fact, it still says that, but when you click watch trailer, it shows the original zombies reveal trailer where the developers talk about D-Machina and how zombies has changed. As of making this video, there's no new trailer here, and I would assume since the website got updated, we can expect a trailer either later today or tomorrow. I know it sounds kind of weird for a trailer to release on a Thursday or a Friday, but it wouldn't be the first time that that's happened. I should also mention that that's the only change made to the website, and that is the message itself. There are private videos over on the YouTube channel of Call of Duty that haven't been unprivated. These are found within the Black Ops Cold War playlist, so I would assume one trailer is going to be for Outbreak, the other is most likely a launch trailer for Season 2, since we've already gotten the cinematic trailer. It's only a matter of time before these things go live. Treyarch, over the past couple of days, have also been teasing this new experience on their Twitter account with these two GIFs that you can see right here. We've already talked about one of them, showing what seems to be some sort of, like, cathedral or church setting. The other is showing an overview of the city, and this is probably all in the same specific area of a new fire team map that we don't have yet. There was a final image posted late last night by Treyarch, and it's a message to Weaver saying, "Having reviewed the reconnaissance photos, I can confirm that these are the largest Ethereum crystals yet encountered, and they are spreading across the region. Air samples in their vicinity suggest they're altering the atmosphere itself. We should schedule a chat at your earliest convenience regarding the likelihood of potential terraforming." And that's from Strauss. So this image is of Ruka, and we can see that there's, you know, obviously a huge Ethereum crystal just coming out of the ground there. This is an out-of-bounds section that you can't get to in Ruka, but here's the same exact tree, the same exact area that I would assume this photo was taken from. One giant thing to keep in mind is all of these maps are taking place in the Ural Mountains. We've already seen Treyarch mention the Ural Mountains, and there's been rumors for the past few months now that we're going to see one gigantic Warzone map with basically all of these locations we have in Fireteam combined. And that makes sense to me, considering that's exactly what we saw with Verdansk in Modern Warfare. When is that going to release? We don't entirely know. How is that going to work is another question altogether. Are we going to see Warzone shift into Black Ops Cold War and take over that movement and swimming and all that different type of stuff? Or are we going to see it stay where it's at right now and have those maps kind of placed into the Modern Warfare engine where we don't have swimming and we don't have boats? And we know that there's maps like Sanatorium where half of it is just water. So I don't entirely think that it would make sense adding it to the Modern Warfare engine unless Modern Warfare itself ended up getting boats and swimming. So I guess we're gonna have to wait and see just exactly what happens. But I personally would like to see it come over to Black Ops Cold War just because I would like to see every part of the map open. You know, it'd be kind of weird if you jumped into the water and you immediately died because you weren't supposed to go into it. It wouldn't make any sense. Playable area should be playable area. And yeah, I think that's the most confusing thing right now. So let me know what y'all think about that down below in the comments section. So finally, to wrap up this video, because it's going to be a short one, I just want to let y'all know that I personally think the trailer is either going to drop later today or tomorrow. I simply wanted to put this video up to let you all know that this is what's been going on. It has now inadvertently been officially announced that the new Zombies experience is Outbreak, coming directly from the Call of Duty website. And even though it was done as a pretty big oopsie, I'm very, very excited to see just exactly what they have planned for the future of Warzone and for the future of Zombies, because this is going to be a huge experience moving forward. I'm very, very excited to play. We've already talked about these rumors before, but imagine popping into Sanatorium. It's night, or, you know, the Ethereum crystals have changed the way the map looks altogether. We have tons of zombies coming through, multiple gigantic ordos walking through the background, and you can actually fight them, and you can go there, and you can climb on the rooftops, and everything would be explorable. It would be massive and open and awesome, and I'm very, very excited to see what they do. Anyway, that is it, guys. I really appreciate you coming out to the video. I will have another video later today. If a trailer comes out, we'll do a breakdown. We'll talk all about it. If you guys enjoyed this one, though, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. I'll catch y'all in the next one. Peace.